Hi, my name is Dimitri, and in this video, I'll walk you through the features of the Clockify iOS app. Clockify gives you a way to track time on the go with a mobile app. By default, you can add an entry in manual mode. So let's switch it to the timer mode to see how the timer works. Tap here to switch. By tapping on the timer play button, the timer will automatically start ticking. You can expand the timer to add more details to the entry. For example, you can change the start time, add a detailed description of what you're working on, add a project, task, or a tag, and you can mark the activity as billable or non-billable. To save an entry, simply tap on the stop button and then on save in the top right corner. Now we can see the entry on the tracker page. You can see the total tracked hours for the day here and for the week here. Entries that have a tag and are billable will have those two icons bolded, so you can easily see what's billable and what's not with a quick overview. If you wish to edit an entry, just tap on it and this editing window will pop up. Change any details you want to and don't forget to tap save. You can also quickly continue working on the same activity by sliding an entry to the right. When you slide an entry to the right, you'll have the option to continue or duplicate it, or you can delete it by sliding it to the left. Adding an entry in manual mode works pretty much the same way. Just tap on the arrow in the bottom left to choose the manual mode. Now enter the duration of the activity that you want to log, add the details to the entry, and then tap on Add in the top right corner to save it. To start the timer even faster without opening the app, press and hold the app's icon and you'll get a drop-down menu with multiple options. From there, you can choose to continue the latest activity, start, or stop the timer. You can also track time with the Clockify widget. Go to the widget screen on your iOS by swiping left from the home screen. Now go to the bottom of the screen and tap Edit. Scroll down once more to customize and activate the Clockify widget. Tap on the play button to start a new timer, or on the arrow to see previous activities, so you can quickly continue a previous timer. Besides tracking time on your work activities, Clockify also allows you to track your break hours during the day. Head over to the workspace settings in the web app, find the breaks feature, and enable it by switching the slider on. You can set a default break project for break entries. You do that by choosing one from the list or creating a new one for that purpose. Now, when you open your mobile app and you're in the timer mode, you'll see a coffee cup next to the play button. Swipe the button to switch to break mode. Tap on the coffee cup icon and the timer will start ticking. You can expand the entry to add more details to it, or stop the timer and then edit, the same way you would edit time entries. Recorded break entries will have a coffee cup icon to differentiate them from other time entries. And you can easily filter them later in the report section of the web app. Apart from the tracker, you can also enter time in Clockify via Timesheet. First, let's go and enable Timesheet in the web app, and then you can use it in the mobile app as well. Log into the Clockify web app, click on the three dots next to your workspace name, choose Workspace Settings, and then enable Timesheet. If you don't have recorded entries for that week, you'll see the option to copy last week's entries. If you tap on it, Clockify will copy all of the entries from the previous week. From there, you can edit the entries to match this week's schedule. Tap on the entry that you want to edit, and then choose if you want to change a project or a task. If you'd like to add a new entry to the timesheet, tap on the plus button in the right corner, and then choose a project. Now you can create entries for each day separately. You do this by tapping on the day displayed on that project's window. If you often work on the same things, you can save timesheets as templates. Just tap on Create Template in the bottom of the screen, add the template name, and then tap Done. Now when you open a new week with no entries, apart from the Copy Last Week's Entries option, you'll also see the option to apply a template. Tap on the Apply Template button, choose which template you want to apply, and then Clockify will copy those entries to that week. Now let's go through settings to see how we can customize the app even further. Tap on the list icon in the top left corner, and then choose Settings. First, you can change the theme from the system default to light or dark. Force offline mode allows you to use Clockify without an internet connection. Your time logs will be saved, so once you get back online, everything will be synced. Next, you'll have the option to enable an automatic mobile tag, so that when you open up the web app, you'll know which entries were made on the mobile. In the default project field, you can choose a default project your entries will have whenever you start the timer. Use the last used project as a default one, or choose a specific project from the list. You can always change the project on each entry separately when you track time. In your phone's system settings, you can manage permissions for notifications. To allow Clockify to show you notifications, enable the Allow Notification switcher and customize the notification style. Apart from the settings, you also have profile preferences. Tap on the list icon in the top left, and then on View Profile. Here you can edit your name, password, enable two-factor authentication, and you can finally set the time zone you want to work in. By enabling two-factor authentication, Clockify will send you codes to your email that you need to enter to log into the app. This is a great added level of security in case your phone gets misplaced or something happens to it. If you'd like to change the start of your work week or change the time format, you can check those settings out in the profile preferences of the web app. Moving on to another way you can track time within the app, the calendar. In settings, you can enable calendar integration so that your Clockify calendar will pick up specific events and local holidays for your chosen email address. Now, when you switch to the calendar in the menu, the calendar will show you two columns for each day. The first is filled with your log time entries, and the second one is with meetings or events that's picked up from your calendar. Holidays are visible on the top of each day. To start tracking time on a meeting, for example, click on the event in the calendar, and you'll see the option to either start a timer or copy the event as a time entry automatically. This way you can quickly log all of your meetings during the day. If your team is using the scheduling feature on the web app, all of your published assignments will be visible in the calendar. This way you can quickly start the time entry for them in the same way. In case you want to add a new entry within the calendar, just tap and hold anywhere on the calendar, and then you can add all of the details. In reports, you have a quick overview of all of the tracked activities for your team or for yourself. You can see what percentage of logged activities is billable or non-billable, and you can also see the distribution of tracked time across projects. Keep in mind that more detailed and insightful reports can be found on the web app. One of the more unique features of the mobile app is GPS tracking. This is mostly useful for employees who are visiting client sites or who travel often. With GPS tracking, employees use the mobile app as usual to track their time. But on the web app, you'll be able to replay daily employee routes and see their last active time. In the mobile app, you can also record expenses and submit requests for your time off. Curious about expenses and time off management? Check out our YouTube channel with our other tutorials. And for more details on Clockify's features and how they work, visit our website or help center. Thanks for watching. Bye-bye.